You're watching NBC for New York. And now, David Ushery, Carolyn Gussoff, and Joe Moreno. This is News Channel 4, Weekend Today in New York.
Well, maybe you've decided to buy new furniture. Maybe you even know what you want, but then you get to the store and, oh boy, the confusion sets in. If furniture shopping overwhelms and confuses you, well, the author of a new book, Best Furniture Buying Tips Ever, may be able to help. It's consumer advocate Jennifer Litwin's second book, and Jennifer is nice enough to come in this morning and share some of her knowledge with us. Let's face it, buying furniture is very expensive, so it can be daunting because you know you're making probably one of the most expensive investments of your life. So can you really learn to be a good shopper?
You absolutely can. It's a $71 billion, basically unregulated industry. There's a lot of confusion shopping for furniture. But my hope with these books is to save people time and money and to avoid the costly mistakes that I made when I was starting out.
Now, a lot of people talk about you have to go to North Carolina to buy furniture or to get a good buy, but you actually went undercover in New York and found us some good shops, good stores with almost the same selection and some of the great prices. Tell us a little bit about the stores that you selected to highlight here.
Absolutely. There are three stores that I have here that I went to, and what I was looking for is service, ambience, quality, and price. So one of the stores that I looked at was Foremost Furniture. Most New Yorkers have never heard of it. It's one of the oldest furniture stores in the country.
Mm-hmm. In the garment district.
It's in the garment district. It's on five floors. And the one thing they have that's special here is a three-year written warranty that most retailers will not offer. And they also are on five floors and carry over 100 different vendors.
And Skyscraper, where is that?
Skyscraper is in the Upper East Side on Lexington Avenue between, I think, 72nd and 73rd. They have a wonderful selection of furniture from the mid-1900s and a great assortment of accessories. So if you're not interested in buying furniture, some of these accessories are really spectacular.
And you also found a gem in Soho. Tell us about BDDW.
BDDW was really a find. I love the store because they sell a lot of rustic but very contemporary looking wood furniture. It's all handmade, and Tyler Hayes, who designs the furniture for BDDW, was actually somebody that I just named in my book as one of the top 10 newly discovered furniture designers in North America. Really, really sensational place.
Now, you recommend stores where the salespeople know what they're doing, which is not always the case. Surprisingly, you say that many salespeople are not educated about the merchandise that they're selling. Let's go into some of your tips. First of all, should you pick a place where it appears that the salespeople know the items, or as long as you know what you're buying, it's okay?
Well, the first thing you want to ask any retailer who's selling contemporary furniture is, does the store itself offer a written warranty above and beyond the manufacturer? If they don't, you don't want to shop there because you want to know that you have recourse in case you buy a piece and it's broken when you get it home.
And what about the materials? How important is it to find out what you're actually buying? There's a lot of confusion with that.
Right. Materials are, it's really, truth in advertising is the biggest problem in the furniture industry. Mm-hmm. You might buy a piece and the label says it was made from solid cherry, and you bring it home and you find out it was actually cherry, you know, particle board with a cherry finish.
Right, veneer.
Veneer. So get that in writing.
Okay, now you also recommend that shoppers negotiate. That can be tough. Mm-hmm. Really, the stores expect that you're going to whittle them down on the price?
I think most dealers think that you will. And if you're afraid to negotiate because you really don't know the value of the piece, don't be afraid to ask for things like free assembly, because you'd mm-hmm. be surprised. A lot of dealers will go that extra mile, and the last thing you want to do is have to hire a carpenter to
sure.
put together some 25-piece box.
So chances are you can get something off, if not on the price, maybe on the assembly. And
right.
what about online discounts? A lot of furniture stores actually will sell you furniture cheaper if you get it online.
Yes, and in fact, when we did a research study, we found that some stores like Urban Outfitters offer 30% off online versus going into the store. So it's definitely worth shopping online first.
All right, so before you spend a small fortune on furnishing your home, it's a good idea to educate yourself. Very,
absolutely.
Very good advice. Thank you so much, Jennifer, for joining us this
Thanks,
morning.
Karen.
If you'd like more information about Jennifer Litwin and the furniture buying tips that we just talked about, you can log on to our website, WNBC.com.